I'm going to explain what the difference is between spondylosis, spondylolysis, and spondylolisthesis. All similar sounding. If you get an X-ray report or an MRI report, all similar sounding, but quite different in distinctions. This show, I'm going to break down the definitions, what it means. I'm going to tell you exactly what they're, how they're defined, where the definitions come from, and then show you some images and pictures as well, so you see what they look like on models and as well on X-rays. So if you're excited about today's show, let me know in the comments below. Right, this is Dr. Walter Salubro. I'm a chiropractor in Vaughan, Ontario, Canada. I'm a corrective care chiropractor in Vaughan, Ontario, Canada. I've been a chiropractor now for 20 years. And we offer non-surgical corrective methods to help improve chronic degenerative spinal conditions that usually lead to things like disc bulge, like L4, L5 disc bulge, or L5S1 disc bulge. We see many, many people, and we help them recover from that condition. But it's in the neck, like cervical disc bulges, like C5, C6, conditions like sciatica, leg pain, numbness, tingling. And as well, we work apply non-surgical corrective techniques for working with scoliosis and postural distortions and displacements. And as well, if you catch this later on the replay, be sure to subscribe if you're not a subscriber to my channel. Spondylosis, spondylolysis, spondylolisthesis. So let me just show what the words look like, and then we'll go into each individual one. So we have spondylosis, spondylolysis on the screen, and then spondylolisthesis, okay? So first of all, let me break down. If we look at, let me write this over here so you can see it. So spondylo, so right there, spondylo itself, that's a Greek term for meaning spine, so relating to the spine, okay? Now I'll tell you what this looks, what this means on your actual MRI. So spine, when something's related to the spine, in Greek, ancient Greek typically, it's referred to as spondylo. So when you see the word spondylo, number one thing is we're talking about the spine or the spinal vertebra, okay? So all three of these terms, spondylosis, spondylolysis, and spondylolisthesis, all relate to the spine, okay? So that we know, okay? And I'm sure you know that already, okay? So there's a spine, okay? So let's go into spondylosis, okay? So we have spondylosis, okay? Spondylosis. So now we have the root word, which is spondylo, and then there's cis at the end, okay? So let me write that in here. So we have cis. One second. I do this multitask here, okay? So the word cis, also in Greek, refers to a condition. So it refers to condition, okay? A process. Okay, so typically condition or process. So if you have the word spondylo and then cis after that, it means a condition related to the spine. And oftentimes it means that there's a degenerative condition, a degeneration, some kind of degenerative arthritic change of the spine. That's typically what spondylosis refers to, okay? So spondylosis typically refers to some type of degeneration or arthritic condition of the spine, okay? So I'm gonna show you a model, and then I'm gonna show you some pictures in a moment right on the screen, okay? So we have a spine from the side, lumbar spine. So it should be elliptical from the side, straight from the back, or straight from the front. So we see there's nice smoothness. There's no irritation or disruption or degeneration or loss of disc space. That's a normal spine, okay? Now when we see, I'm going to show a segment now over here, okay? So again, normal, 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 nice and smooth. Now when you see degenerative changes like that, see the difference there, the roughness, okay, right there, the degeneration, that is referred to as spondylosis. So it's a general term meaning that there's degenerative arthritic changes on a spine, okay? Now, let's go into some photographs. So let's see if I can do this here. There we go, okay? But nice and smooth contours, okay? So nice and smooth, there's no arthritic degeneration. Here's an X-ray now, okay? So let me expand this a bit, okay? So again, nice, smooth contour. Let me get my pen in here. Okay, so we don't see any arthritic, so no arthritic changes. Everything looks good, okay? The disc bases look good, so that's normal spine, all right? Now let me show you the spondylosis. Okay, now, so there's a spine model again. You see the degeneration there, So a close up, right? Now over here is an x-ray. It's a bit hard to see. Let me see if I can expand it. See the bony spurs over here, right there? That's a condition of spondylosis. So when you see bony degenerative changes, where these arrows are pointing to, again, there's what's referred to as spondylosis, okay? So it means degenerative change of the spine. General terminology for that is spondylosis. If you see that on your x-rays or MRI reports, okay? Now, next one, okay? Spondylolysis, okay? So spondylolysis. Now, again, the word spondylo, we know that refers to vertebra. Now, the suffix of that, lysis. Now, this word, when you see that at the end of something, that's another Greek term that refers to destruction, loosening, or breaking down, okay? It's often used in cellular explanations of cells, but in this case can be used in bone as well, okay? So when there's breaking down the bone, it's usually referred to as lysis. And then specifically when it's spondylolysis, this is what it looks like, okay? So let me find the picture, okay, and put in the screen. So here's the spine again. If you look carefully, right there, that red line is a break or a disruption, a breakdown of the integrity of that area of the spine. So there's a disruption here, okay? So this is a joint in the spine. Here's a joint in the spine. And in between, it's called pars interarticularis. I'm not going to get too fancy with the words. Don't worry about the details. Just get the big picture. When there's a disruption or a break, that's called a lysis. Because it refers to the spine, that's called spondylolysis, right? Sometimes it causes pain, sometimes it doesn't. Sometimes a spondylolysis is caused by a traumatic fall to the spine or some kind of trauma, or sometimes it's just degenerative, and sometimes it's just a pars defect, which is also a spondylolysis, that occurred just at birth. It just didn't form properly, okay? And the consequence mean with that is that it can continue to slip forward, and I'll show you that in a moment, or it just stays like that and it's aligned properly. But essentially, when there is a disruption, break, or defect in between the two joints, superior and inferior joint, right in there, that's called spondylolysis. Okay, very important. Okay, now, again, from the backside. Okay, from the backside. So sometimes we catch this on x-rays like this, either in the lateral view or the frontal view, possibly, most likely the lateral, and on a special view called an oblique view. But you can see that they're pointing to the spine here. There'll be a break in either one and most often two. Okay, so it's called spondylolysis. Okay, that's what that is. Okay, next picture. Now let me show you an x-ray. Okay, so x-ray. So again, lumbar spine, right? So if I can get my coloring tool to work now. Okay, so this is normal. Okay. And over here, you see a break right in there, okay, a disruption. So when you catch that on an actual x-ray, then it needs to be dealt differently chiropractically. We don't usually adjust this area, and then we need to determine if it's stable or not, okay? Now, you see how this is aligning fairly well. It's a little bit slippage, but fairly well, okay? So there's no disruption or slippage here yet, but it could lead to that. So that's an example right there of a spondylolysis. Okay, so we have another one. Okay, so we went through the first two definitions. We're going to go into the next one now, which is spondylolisthesis. That's coming up next. Okay, so I'm going to put this together. Okay, so here's another example of another lysis. Okay, so again, a disruption. I'm not going to draw, but you see the arrow moving right there. Okay, now the difference now is that this disruption or spondylolysis contributed to a slippage forward of this vertebra. So it's the L5 vertebra. So when there's a listhesis, spondylo refers to spine, listhesis refers to a slippage. So a slippage or slide, slip or slide. So the L5 vertebra and the entire column above it, but we name it in relation to L5, slipped forward. So the spondylolysis with a corresponding spondylolisthesis, okay? So that's what a listhesis is, to slip forward. Now, when it goes forward, so spondylolisthesis typically refers to a forward slippage or anterior, so the front of the body's here, the back of the body's here. When it's going forward, it's referred to as an anterior listhesis. Anterior refers to forward. sometimes it slips backwards, not typically because of a pars defect or a lysis, but sometimes it slips backwards. It's called the retro backwards, retro listhesis. Okay. But right now we're talking about forward spondylolisthesis or anterior listhesis. So kind of interchangeable terminology, spondylolisthesis and anterior listhesis. In this case, as an added note, there's a loss of disc space here as well. So there could be a contributing disc problem in there, which needs to be confirmed on MRI on this one here. Okay, so we get a lot of information from x-rays. Let's go to the next one. Now, over here, okay, so over here you have L4 slipped forward in relation to L5. So it's an anterior listhesis, forward slippage of L4 on L5. Okay, so that's another example of a spondylolisthesis. And it looks like there's a break in there. The light is very bright in my eyes, but it looks like there's a break in there as well. So there's a corresponding spondylolysis as well. Okay, and then sometimes we catch these on lateral x-rays, and we need to confirm it because maybe it's not too visible. So we take what's called oblique, 45 degrees turned body position on x-ray. We get a nice image of the pars or that area of the spine, and we can verify that. Okay, let's go to the next one. Here's another one. So now let's talk about stability, right? So these are graded. Spondylolisthesis or anterior listhesis are graded. And I'll show you the grading system in a moment. This one's at 25% or less. So it's on the more stable side. However, there could still be some motion, added motion in there that's not good. This can cause pain, it can cause shear on the actual discs, shear straining. There's compression on the discs because of the loss of disc height. So there's added abnormal stress and strain on the disc, which can be a pain contributor. The slippage forward can irritate the nerves, can cause nerve pain down the leg, can cause lower back pain, gluteal pain, hip pain. Okay, so very serious situation, needs to be addressed properly. Okay, so the next one, okay, this is L4 is over here, and then L5 is here. Okay, so let's expand that a bit. Okay, so here's the sacrum, S1 and the rest of the sacrum, L5, okay, L5, all right? So now this one is close to a 50% slippage, which this person would need to be referred to an orthopedic surgeon for further assessment and to see if they need stabilizing surgery, okay? Because that can be very dangerous. So almost complete loss of disc space at L5 S1. So obliteration of disc space. It's hard to see if there's a pars defect, so the person will need an oblique view to confirm that. But if this person came into my office, they would be referred to their medical doctor or an orthopedic specialist for further evaluation, and they will determine if they require surgery to stabilize that or not. So, but this can cause much neurologic compromise, lots of pain in the back, pain in the disc-related area, and then, of course, in the legs as well. So this is close to a 50%. So we take the point from here to here and go into quadrants. And if it's more than 50, it can be more on the more unstable side. But there's probably lots of motion in here anyway. So we do other tests called flexion and extension views to see if there's any added motion in there. So let's take a look at the next picture, which I actually think is the last one. And you see the grading system. Okay. So now all my other pictures, everyone's facing this way. So here's the front and here's the back. This one, I didn't flip the picture because I wanted you to see the grading system. So this person, this is the backside, and now there's the front. So here's the vertebra, L5. Here's the sacrum at the bottom. And you see the grading system. So this divided into quadrants, so four, okay, four sections. That's halfway point, so quarter. Okay, each one's a quarter. So this one slipped forward just under 25%. So it's more on the stable side. There could be some abnormal motion, but more on the stable side. If they're within the 50 and above range, then they require a surgical consultation, okay? So that's a spondylolisthesis. There you go. So that covers spondylosis, spondylolysis, spondylolisthesis. If you found that useful, please let me know. All right, gang. So I hope you found this useful. Don't forget to subscribe, click the notification bell. Leave any other questions in the comments below. I'll get to them later. And this is Dr. Walter Salubro. You're from Vaughan, Ontario, Canada. Chiropractor in Vaughan, Ontario, Canada.